Hi everyone and welcome to Open Source Tonight. Today I want to talk about some of the things that separate macOS and Linux. One thing that's different is there's really no package manager. So like with the GNOME, not the GNOME, with Linux, you've got package managers like apt. Doesn't exist. Okay? You've got packages like DNF, package managers like DNF. You've got the yum package manager. You've got pacman. As you can see, none of those commands exist. So if you are wanting to use your Mac and be able to install stuff from the command line easy, there is third-party utilities like Mac ports and such that exist that will allow you to install software in a package manager style. But Linux has package managers and macOS really doesn't. At least not out of the box. Just like Windows kind of doesn't, it's complicated because they kind of have one now. Anyway, regardless of that, they do have an app store, and a lot of Linux distributions do actually run a said app store. So, like, for example, if I launch the app store, there it is. But, again, the reality of it is you're going to want to use a package manager, potentially. Another thing is Linux is really used a lot on servers and in the data center. macOS, not so much from what I can gather. So there is important real distinctions. Another big distinction to make about macOS as far as the difference goes. macOS, from a philosophy standpoint, is proprietary software. macOS is a Unix OS certified to be Unix that is based off of Darwin, an open source operating system based on, if memory serves, I think it's FreeBSD that Apple created years ago. So technically speaking, the base of macOS is open source, and you will find a lot of cool Unix-like and Unix things, like grep is here, nano is here. In fact, I bet you if we open, let's just see. Look at that, VI is here. Another big difference is the fact that macOS is only supposed to be installed on computers with one of these logos on it, the Apple logo. And I don't think taking a sticker of the Apple logo counts. Not a lawyer. But anyway, the thing about it is macOS as an operating system is really only supposed to, according to the end-user license agreement, be installed on Apple-branded computers. Again, Apple's own Macs. And so by definition, you're not really supposed to officially install it on anything else. Some people have hackintoshed their systems in the past, so it's clearly in the past has been possible, but it doesn't mean that you're supposed to. Linux, on the other hand, the software is free. Almost every Linux distribution out there is license-free and literally will just let you download an ISO. And when you're done with that ISO on your USB key that you've set up to install on all your systems, let's say Ubuntu, for example, you can give it to your buddy. It's totally cool. Again, macOS, not so much. And by not so much, I mean nope, at least not officially. So the moral of the story is Linux is definitely a more open platform. But I have a feeling the viewers of Open Source Tonight, you already knew that. What is a more fundamental difference? Well, macOS, one difference is it doesn't really have something like systemd that I'm aware of for managing services. I'm sure it's got an architecture that does it. I actually don't know for sure. I'm doing this video on the fly, but as far as I know, it doesn't have one. If you know if it does have something like this, I mean, it clearly has services, every OS does, but I'm curious, like, what does it have? I haven't fully figured that out. I just know it has services of some kind. So it sounds to me like, and you all probably picked up on this, that Linux is really good in the data center. But what about on the desktop? Well, it can be great there too. You know, on macOS, you get one desktop environment. You get this one. Now, I personally like it, but what if you didn't? Well, if you were running Linux instead of macOS, no big deal. Install KDE, or install GNOME, or install the Mate desktop, or install XFCE. You get where I'm going with this. There's a lot of choice. Or if you're a really big nerd and got a lot of time on your hands, you could actually build your own desktop environment if you really wanted something that nobody else had created. Again, Linux gives you the tools so you can actually play around in the workshop and basically build almost anything. macOS, on the other hand, they want to spoil all the fun. Okay, maybe not all the fun, but they want you to use their stuff. Now, to be fair, macOS doesn't let you install your own programs and things like that, but it's just, it's a different experience. You know, it's not as open as Linux. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying it's different. In fact, I like macOS. I use Windows, macOS, and Linux every day for those that are wondering. Something that macOS seems to have more of than Linux does from a desktop standpoint. Now, there has been vulnerabilities in both. Apple and Linux generally seems to patch things pretty quick. So from a security standpoint, they're pretty similar. Regardless, the reality of it is that you really want to pick, in my mind, the platform that makes sense for you. Linux, I think, really makes a lot of sense in the data center. It makes a lot of sense for somebody that's used to that workflow or likes that workflow. So for example, for me, I really am used to the GNOME 3 desktop and the way it works. And some of those things you can find in other OSs like macOS. For example, if I do, well, oh, I don't have anything open, so it's kind of not as cool looking. I already shot this video once. But let's say I put my terminal there. If I do this now, see, now it starts to be more noticeable. But you can do something like that. And you can see your open programs and everything like a workspace kind of view. That is true. In fact, Mac, Windows, Linux, all three does that these days. But if memory serves, I believe GNOME did it first. And you will find that where in Linux, Windows, and Mac that they copy each other. This is not news to probably anybody watching this video. The reality of it is, though, you don't have all the features of the GNOME desktop in macOS. One thing I've gotten really used to is being able to press the super key or the Windows key or the command key, whatever you want to call it, on your system and be able to open up and instantly start searching for something. So let's say I need a text document. I know the name of it. I just go super key, search important document, hit enter when it opens, and there it is. You can't do that in macOS. I'm sure you've got Spotlight and Windows has got a way to search with the search menu, but these are slightly different workflows. And a lot of this stuff, again, really just comes down, if you ask me, to what you like from a philosophy standpoint, what you like from where you can install it. For me, one of the things I love about Linux is the fact that I can install it on anything. macOS, not so much. So for example, Linux, like Debian, they've got PowerPC, ARM, they've got Intel/AMD x86 32-bit support stuff, all that, okay? Compare that to a macOS, where you have to run an Apple-branded hardware, you're running their architecture specifically, you're running their hardware. For plenty of users, this is fine, but if you're like me and you're a techie and if you're watching this channel, you probably are, you might really want the level of control that you can get from a Linux install. So if you haven't tried Linux, I think it might be time to give it a try. It might not be for you, it might be. I personally really like it, and I think for a lot of people it is. But anyway, folks, I hope you found this video interesting and or informative. Thank you so much for watching Open Source Tonight. And I don't know if you noticed, by the way, before I say goodbye, there's a couch here. Yeah, this is an early Christmas gift from a family member. So I think it blends in with the space quite well and looks nice. Anyway, everybody, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again very soon. Goodbye, everybody. And action.